Behind me is a system that is not operating at its optimum pressure. Now, I know for a fact that it used to work just fine. So something has happened recently to create this problem. Another thing to point out is it's not isolated at just one valve. It is a system-wide problem. So to do our troubleshooting, we need to go to the water source. We also need to have the right instrument to do the job correctly. And when diagnosing pressure problems, you have to have a pressure gauge. The first thing we need to know is how much pressure a properly designed system needs to start off with at the source and how much pressure it's going to lose from beginning to end. Now, a typical well-designed system will lose 15 pounds from beginning to end. But there is an exception, and those are systems with reduced pressure assembly backfill devices. Those systems lose 25 pounds. Now, in the system that we have here, we have a reduced pressure assembly, so this system will lose 25 pounds. Behind me is a head that requires 40. So if I have a head that requires 40 and I lose 25 pounds, I have to start off at the source with 65 pounds of static pressure. Now the 15 and 25 pounds of pressure loss is a rule of thumb to help you with your troubleshooting. There are a lot of factors that can affect these values, but the 15 pounds of loss can be broken down even further to 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You'll lose about 5 pounds of pressure loss through a water meter, 4 through the backfill device, 3 pounds of loss through a valve, 2 pounds through a main line, and about 1 pound through the lateral line. The breakdown for systems that lose 25 PSI is 5, 14, 3, 2, 1. Because a reduced pressure assembly backfill device loses around 14 pounds of pressure instead of 4. Now to conduct our test, we need to go to the backfill device. Okay, so here we are at the reduced pressure assembly backfill device, and this is where we're going to do our test. I'm going to go to the very first test cock. As the water is flowing this way, this is the first test cock that it comes into. This is actually going to test the pressure before the backfill device. About 5 feet away from here is the water meter on the supply side. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the gauge right here, and I'm going to test my static pressure. Now, if you'll remember, the head that I have out there needs 40 pounds. A system that has this type of backfill device will lose 25 pounds. So for this system to work, to begin with, I need at least 65 pounds of static pressure. I'm gonna open this test cock and see what the static pressure is. Static pressure is when water is not in motion. Okay, I have 90 pounds of static pressure. That is more than enough for this system to work. I verified that I have enough pressure to begin with, so now what I need to do is turn this system on to see what the dynamic pressure goes down to. Now, I told you earlier that the breakdown is 5, 14, 3, 2, 1. I expect to only lose 5 pounds because between here and the city main line, all I really have is a water meter. Okay, so I was expecting my gauge to go down by 5 pounds because we talked about the breakdown being 5, 14, 3, 2, 1. But I didn't lose 5 pounds. My gauge went down to 40 PSI, which means I lost 50 pounds of pressure when it went from static to dynamic. I know for a fact that there is a restriction from here to the city main line. Now, at 40 pounds here, it's not going to leave me enough pressure at the head because I still have another 14, 3, 2, 1 pounds of pressure to lose, which will leave me with something like 20 pounds of pressure at the head. I did find out that there is a gate valve between here and the meter, so I'm going to go make sure it's opened up all the way because that could be our problem. Okay, so it turns out that the problem was in the gate valve after all, and that ends up being a pretty easy fix for us. But it doesn't really always work out like that. Sometimes we have to dig up the entire line from the backfill device to the meter to see what could have been causing the problem. In some cases, you might dig up an old piece of galvanized pipe that's corroded, or an old pressure regulator that doesn't work. Or you might find out that it is not a problem at all on your side. And if that's the case, the problem is on the city side, and you'll need to call them to get them involved. Another situation might happen when you do your test and you just lose the expected 5 pounds of loss. That means that your restriction now is on the downstream side. So I'm going to take my gauge, move it to the last test cock, test my loss across the device. If that checks out, then I know that my restriction is on the downstream side of the backfill device. For more in-depth training on this subject and more, you can attend one of our live education classes. Stop by your local Ewing branch to find out how, or visit us online at ewingirrigation.com.